Hello all, I'm Dr. Gayatri, an educational therapist. I'm the founder of Flourishing Kids and I work with kids having learning difficulties. Today, we are going to discuss a parent question. A parent has asked me specifically, how to teach meanings for the words to kids? My kid always asks some word and what should I do? How should I teach the kid to know the meaning for the word? Yes, let's see how we can do that. First thing is the dictionary. Yes, dictionary is always useful. Either you can have a normal dictionary or an online dictionary. But the point is that when the child is looking into the dictionary, you also can check along with the child. If you just look at the dictionary, maybe the words in the dictionary would be little different. So look along with the child. Yes, both of you can look together. Yeah, there you can both look together what is the word and what is the meaning. Let's take a small example. If your child is asking, curious, what is curious? Okay, so first you both are opening out the dictionary and then you're checking out the word. What is curious? Curious, as per the dictionary, it is eager to know or learn something. Once the child understands what it is, maybe you read it out for them after they read it. Then you explain them maybe in a sentence. I am curious to know what my birthday gift would be. Yes, you can make it into a sentence and explain to the kid. Then it will be much more understanding and the kid can understand it very well. After you explain them in the sentence, ask them to give the meaning in their own words. Not to repeat what they have seen in the dictionary or what you told, from their own words. They can give the meaning in their own words. Maybe your kid can say, interesting, that is curious. Yes, that's correct. And then ask the kid, can you try forming a sentence with curious? Yes, the child can come with different sentences if you ask them to try it out. Then the child can retain the meaning for a longer period of time. They would be able to remember it. Okay, so this is one technique. Suppose your kid is very small and they are asking something, they want to see it. Yeah, if your kid is too small and you are just singing some nursery rhymes or something, maybe I'm a little teapot, short and stout. You are explaining everything about short, stout, everything. But the kid doesn't understand what is teapot, how does it look like? So you can actually show the object itself. You can just show what is real. This is the object and you can explain them. If you're not able to get the object, obviously we can take and we can show them a photo. You can just project it and we could show that this is the photo and this is how the teapot will look like. Then the kid can understand better. This one would work if it is like a thing. We can always do this. If we can express it in a picture or anything, then the kid would be able to retain it longer time. The next one, we can ask the kids to draw a picture. Like now we are seeing about teapot. Maybe we can ask after that to draw a teapot. If I'm discussing a word like curious and I said a sentence about the birthday gift, maybe you ask them to draw a simple drawing with that sentence so that they retain it for longer time also. They would be able to visualize it much better and they're drawing their own picture. So they understand it far better. For little older kids, you can move on to the next level and we can discuss with them about the synonyms and antonyms. Synonyms are the words with the same meaning. Whatever I said for curious with the same meaning, which are the words over for synonyms, and antonyms, which is not the meaning, it's the opposite of it. So those are called antonyms. So you can discuss like that, which words would be falling under synonyms and which would be like antonyms. That way their vocabulary keeps increasing. They are understanding one word and they are able to know more than that. Maybe they would be able to tell more about the word in the next few days. Next, the important thing what we should do at home is that we have to start using the same word again and again in some different spots. It is just one word, you'd be easily using it. It is curious. You can just say like, I'm curious to know what my supper would be or anything like that. Just use the word and again for the next week so that your kid remembers the word very well and they retain the meaning also for long lasting time. So just don't stop with the dictionary alone. Looking at the dictionary is one way, but you have to progress it further. You have to look into different things. Then only the meaning will retain for a longer time. Just try it out with your kids. Thank you all.